Hello everyone, welcome to DesignCorner. In today's video, I will show you how to create a pipe clamp in CreoParametric. This is the sheet metal part that I designed, with the only critical feature being the curved form. This is the part we will be designing today, and I will also demonstrate how to create the flat pattern in CreoParametric. So let's get started. To start this part, go to new. For the type, select part, and for the subtype, choose sheet metal. Next, assign a name like pipe clamp sheet metal. Uncheck the default template option and click OK. Here I am selecting the inch LBS option and clicking OK. I will make the planes visible, and when we will start the part, first select the top datum plane and click on the extrude feature. Then set it to normal too. I will start the sketch with a vertical center line. Next, I will draw a circle like this. And after that, I will add two continuous lines. Just like this. I will mirror the lines using this center line. To do this, select the two lines and click the mirror icon and select center line as reference. Now you can see the lines are mirrored. Now we need to add the dimensions to this sketch using normal dimensioning icon. I will set the diameter of the circle to 6 and the distance between the line endpoints to 10. After that, we need to delete the unwanted lines in the sketch using the delete segment option, like this. Once the sketch is done, click OK. After that, we need to select the sketching plane as symmetric. I will set the height to 2 and the sheet thickness to 0.12. Next, we need to set the bending radius to 0.30, then click OK. We have completed the first feature. Next, we will see how to create the critical form portion in this curved area. The first thing we need to do is flatten or unbend the part. So I am selecting the unbend icon. After that, we need to select the face. If we select the face, it will be moved either to this side or the opposite side, meaning it's not symmetric. To create a symmetric flat pattern, we need to do split the part. I will now show you how to split the part evenly. Here I am selecting the split area feature and choosing this plane, then setting it to normal too. Next, I draw a vertical line and click OK. You can see that the part is now split. Using the split, I will be unbend the part. So click the unbend icon, select the reference for the split center line, and then click OK. Now you can see that the part is unbent symmetrically. Next, we need to create the form feature. Here we are using the quilt form feature. To create the quilt form, I will use the revolve option. So go to model, click shapes and select the revolve option. Then change the type from part to surface. Next, click the placement tab and define the reference to this plane. Click sketch and then click Normal too. To create the center line for the revolve feature, I will first draw a center line and set the distance between the face and the line to 0.3. After that, I will draw a line and constrain it to be symmetric between the two points using the vertical center line. Then I will draw an arc and mirror it. Next, I will give the dimension between the points as 14.5. Set the distance of the line to 0.5. And set the arc radius to 0.5. Then click OK. Now, set the center axis to be symmetric and the angle to 180 degrees. And then click OK. You can see that the revolve surface has been created. Next, drop down the form menu and select the Quilt Form option. Click on Reference and select the surface we created. Change the direction. Then click OK. The form feature is now created. After that, we need to bend it back. Select the Bend Back option. Click the reference as the center line and then click OK. After that, I am clicking the extrude option to create the edges like a bend. I will draw a vertical center line, then a circle, and constrain it tangentially with the edges. I change the direction, then click OK again. Now I am mirroring the feature. To do this, click the Edit option, then select Mirror feature. I select this plane and click OK. Now I want to create two holes on both sides, so I am using the Extrude option and again selecting the face where I want to make the hole. To create the hole, I draw a horizontal center line, then a circle with 0.5 diameter. After that, I mirror a circle using the mirror option. I then define the dimension from the hole center to hole center as 8. The pipe clamp part is done. Now I will create the flat pattern. First, click the bend back feature and select the center reference line. That's it. We now have the flat pattern and the part is complete. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe for more content.